mercy to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, and our friend. Amen. So here we are, humans with our critters, or in the case of the ordinary ones, pictures of our critters. This is kind of fun, right? Blessing pets. But why are we doing it? Why are we blessing animals on Francis's feast day? For that matter, why are we blessing animals at all? Legends, of course, talk about Francis preaching to the birds. He also is said to have negotiated a peace treaty with a wolf and a village. So the big bad wolf and the little Italian village. This is why Francis is connected with animals. And this is why we bless them around October 5th. But I would suggest that there is a little more to Francis and a little more to blessing animals than simply big bad wolves and birds who listen. Let us pray. Lord God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Lord God, may the preacher decrease that you might increase. Amen. Francis is a fascinating fellow. He was born rich, went off to war, where he saw many of his friends die. He was captured and imprisoned for a time, so he's a POW. And he came out of all that deeply disturbed. And in this state, shell-shocked by the roughness of this world, he took a Bible, he opened it up, and he read several simple commands of Christ. So it's one of those, you open up the Bible and go, ooh, whoop. He finds these commands of Christ. Sell all you have. Give to the poor. Deny yourself. And that could be strange, I suppose. But what's stranger still, crazy even, is that he did it. Now, Paul might describe this as carrying the marks of Jesus on his body. Matthew might describe what Francis did as taking up Christ's yoke. Whatever you want to call it, this action changed Francis's life and changed the world. He was able to find God in the face of lepers who he served, find God as well, living a life at the essential nub, labor, prayer, sacrament. His life inspired his friends and expanded out beyond this initial circle of friends and created a movement, calling people to a life of discipleship, following after Christ in a new and strange world. This movement challenged the political games that the church of the time was playing. The ways in which the church had wedded itself to wealth and power and riches and might. Some go so far as to say that the 12th century church was rebuilt on the back of this simple man from Assisi. And I think Francis's example can inspire us as well. It can remind us that we are called to be little Christs to our neighbor. Remind us to carry the mark of Christ, and remind us that we carry the yoke of Christ. That it's easy and it's light, the yoke of Christ is, but not, understand me, because it's effortless or uncomplicated or painless, but instead because it is life-giving. You get what I'm saying, right? Living in such a way that you become more in tune with the teaching and the style of life of Jesus, kissing lepers or facing popes or flipping your whole life around and accepting a life of self-denial, as Francis did. This was not a walk in the park, but it was good. In this radical humility, living life at its most basic level can bring us face to face with God. It can help us see Jesus among the least of these, but also capture a sense of grace in creation. Base grace, the basic joy of being. God has created all that is, seen and unseen, and we're part of it. Wow, right? I don't know, I think it's pretty wow. And that, right there, is one of the reasons we bless animals. A blessing is a call to vocation. We bless teachers, for example, that they might more fully live into teaching. We bless architects, carpenters, and construction workers, that they might more fully live in their creative life. And so we too, we bless critters, that they might more fully be part of that goodness of being. The goodness that a human might find by selling all you have, giving to the poor and denying yourself. The goodness of living on the nub of life. A goodness I can only imagine puppies and kitties and gerbils and bees, right, Randy? And all those creatures know better than most of us ever will. Yes, we bless animals so that they might more fully be what they are, created good, nestled against the pulse of that goodness that runs deep through the world, profoundly aware that first of that first grace bestowed upon us all. Amen and hallelujah.